we're super excited because we are now at the BMW booth, and I have here with me Oliver, who is the head of interior design of BMW, and he's going to talk us through a bit about the car and the concept of this BMW 9 series. Yeah. So
thank you very much. I think what we did with this car is to talk about future luxury. What means future luxury for us? And overall, there are two main words. It's precision and poetry. So both main themes are we connecting together, which might be at first glance a struggling difference, but they match perfect together, and this is what we expressed with this concept vehicle. Precise lines, precise details, but really high emotional surfaces in the exterior and as well in the interior.
Well, is there any specific highlights or the design that you personally like?
Actually, I like the overall sculpture, honestly. But what something special is that everything we did has a certain function. For example, the headlights really narrow, which shows the high-end technology of LED technology, laser light. So then a feature what you can see from here is you see the air breather, which is a part of the design, which is a part of this whole process. Something special which we are really proud of is the connection between exterior and interior. And if you see the structure in carbon fiber, which is in a luxury segment, it's totally new. The structure is growing into the seat, so it's a part of the seat structure. So what we did is there is not a normal connection, a normal interruption between exterior and interior. It's one fluid surface.
That's right.
And it's both. It's design and it's function. So the car is really stiff. We can do this kind of door opening, we say suicide doors, but it's still stiffer than a normal car.
Right, it looks really luxurious too.
Yeah, this was another, let's say by the names, poetry and precision, we said, okay, let's get rid of as many buttons as possible.
Okay.
Let's get rid of as many shut lines as possible. If there is a shut line, it should be really precise. Our mental model behind that was to kind of mill out of a monovolume, mill out any different surface. So in the first step you're milling, they're coming out of the wood. The next step is maybe this high-end galvanized piece here. And the next step is the information displays. And that's a further step ahead for us from our point of view. That was happening in the screens. User interface is different. And we think in the future, a big part of luxury happens in a virtual world, not just only in a material. Material will be something which is, for us, as premium. It's something normal, let's say. Everyone would expect that from us. What you don't expect at the moment is that there's so much convenience in the user interface you can play with.
True.
And that is the next step for us. We were talking about a communication system, which is the next step. Maybe you remember the Vision connected drive. This is the next step of it. It's communicating with outside. We have on the left side of the instrument cluster, we have this concierge service, which means traffic light assistance. Yep. So you see how long the traffic light is still red.
Right.
We have autonomous driving. You have any suspension features in this. So this is something which is just for the driver, just for him. Safety
for the
reasons,
pleasure of the
things
driver.
Like that. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
The instrument cluster for sure, basic information, and we have a really huge, big head-up display, which has an analogy towards the surrounding.
I
so it's as huge that it could reach a traffic light, for example. You see, the screen is starting up now. You see the connection between all over those screens. It's one theme which is running through. And we are everything you see there is created in 3D. So there are 3D parts behind it. It's not a JPEG anymore. It's built in 3D. For that reason, we are totally, we could do everything we want to do with those surfaces here. Yeah? if you see now, there's an impulse coming in from, I think it's the information. See what's happening there.
I see, yes, yes.
You can reach that really, really good. There's an information about, okay, you cannot drive far faster than that what you see here.
Right, right. Wow, that's really awesome.
Yeah, so there's a lot of behind that first glance, which is important for us as well to make this experience. Now what you see is the traffic light assistant.
Mm.
It's counting. In the head-up display, you're seeing what you can see now.
Yeah.
You see, okay, it's green now, and you start driving again.
Okay. Right.
In the center display, in the CID, we have the main stage, let's say this way, where you can switch the content from behind, somewhere behind, towards the front. And you can choose whatever you want to have there. But what you see is, the information is really, let's say, condensed, really reduced to that what's important.
What is important, what's pertinent,
Not everything at every time. Mm-hmm. Now you see the content of autonomous driving and it's coming back now to normal.
Right.
So
okay.
Its appearance is changing.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh.
The passenger has a narrow wide display. And what we did is, there is coming in then an information from you're driving to the opera. This was the story you are telling. While driving to the opera, there's coming an information from outside, from the opera. You get a ticket.
Mm.
The ticket comes into the car by information. You swipe it towards the passenger. The passenger sees where you're sitting, if everything is prepared there.
Okay.
The rear passenger could get more information about opera. We're talking about the Tosca from Puccini.
Right.
Where you can get something. You see it from here.
Mm-hmm.
Recommendations for the meal in between.
Yes,
you see, the remaining time driving, things like that.
Then you know I will never get out of this car.
That's what you want.
It's the journey and the destination that counts.
It's actually imagine most of us are spending more and more time in the car.
That's
so what
true,
what do we need to do with that time?
Mm-hmm.
Normally, you should do something which you want to do, right? It's a business.
Yes,
it is.
Right.
It's recreation. We should talk about recreation. Sometimes, for many of us as managers, it's the only place where you can.
You spend a lot more time in the car,
right?
Transporting from one meeting to another meeting.
Exactly.
That's right. That's right.
And this is important for us.
All right. Cool. Thank you so much. Yes.
This is maybe a little bit more than 2 minutes. Sorry.
But it's great. Yeah. Thank you so much for the information, Oliver. It's great to meet you. Thank you.
Thank you.